Snobby got a messy one.
Yeah, Nobby's been due for a bad day.
How?
He's been winning all week with the cards. Always watch it when you flush.
Is this it?
Is this what?
The hill we're supposed to take, Chunuk Bair.
Don't ask me, mate. I only work here.
Well, Nobby didn't know me either. It has to be.
Has to be.
Chunuk Bair.
Oh, the bastards look all the same when you're up here.
Where is that sod? Come on, Smarter! Larry and Dad's that way! Go!
Rookie,
what? I'm still not very good at this. Don't lose heart, mate! Neither's General Surrey and Hamilton.
And that's sedition!
No, Smiler! Inspiration, mate! He says we're all sharing a glorious adventure. Unprecedented in modern war.
Oh, what's that mean?
He hasn't got a bloody clue neither.
Oh, we go up here too quick. We should wait. So there.
Go on, guess.
Oh, more August defensive, more bloody active.
And maybe the Dardanelles.
The Dardanelles?
Jesus, Smiler. What do you use to keep your ears apart? We're not up here just for a blue with the Abdul's. We're here for the Dardy bloody Nels!
You don't have to go on about it.
And today, we might even see what they look like.
I've seen enough of what they look like.
But we've never seen the Dardy Nels.
I mean Abdul's. They're not much better dead.
Oh, we got up here too quick. Sergeant Frank's enough to race too far ahead.
Tell old Nobby. He's a bit out of breath.
Sergeant French had come to expose ourselves unnecessarily.
I've got news for him, mate. I'm not up here to flash, right? So let's have a gander over the top. Where is that song?
Sergeant French.
He's not Sergeant Jesus bloody Christ. We got to do him first.
Oh, I can't. I've got the shits again.
Try nervous piss.
I know what I've got.
Scared shits or regular?
Dysentery.
There you go again, Smiler. Only officers get dysentery, mate. We get Gallipoli gallop. Go on, get it over with. Not in front of me. Take your Turkish two-step behind a bush.
Oh, I'd hate to get shot with my trousers off.
You're no oil painting with them on. Remember, don't expose yourself unnecessarily.
There, see what I mean?
Go on. Just one little snipe.
It's not worth it.
I thought Gallipoli swung on it a moment ago.
I saw him that time, that way. Behind the biggest boulder.
Why are you telling me?
I thought you should know.
You thought I should bloody know.
He could have been hit with last night's shelling, just me lying there.
Oh, I can hear them now. What did you do in the war, Granddad?
Well, I climbed old Chunuk Bair, kids. I climbed old Chunuk Bair to do it too. So my mate Smiler could take a quiet crap.
Oh, Jesus. I must or I must.
Look, I filled my bags the day we landed on the beach. Didn't affect the war either way. Looks like another mopping up operation.
Oh, what do you mean?
If that bastard keeps popping that thing off, we could have an avalanche of Abdul's and never see the Dardanelles. I got to do him quiet. He can see you, but he can't see me. Boogie! What is it now?
It's getting lonely.
Oh, don't be a girl! Boogie!
For Christ's sake, Smiler!
Careful!
Oh, so twitch your bum now and then. Give him some scenery.
Oh!
Boogie!
For Christ's sake, Mama! If you don't soldier on with that shit, I'll break you! Fair go!
Are you sure it's alright now?
You're covering fire too!
What happened?
It's gonna be another hot old day.
I said, what happened?
I said, it's gonna be another hot old day.
Oh, what's wrong?
Just a kid.
Another bat will not get into the box.
How do you know we won't get into the box?
I don't see why it worries you, mate. You never bloody read it.
Someone must remember.
Who'd want to remember you? Or Chunuk Bloody Bear? Books are about gallop buckers, and in a few years for all it bloody matters, this might be a lump of a hillside outside Tyre. Jesus! They say they leave you in the end.
Oh, what do?
The light. When you're cool. When you got your issue. Aha! Got it! Been trying to outflank that bastard for 5 weeks.
Oh, how do you tell the difference between gallon buggers and other buggers?
If you read the books, you'd bloody know. They don't shit and scratch. Heroes, mate.
Well, General Sir Ian Hamilton says we're all writing history up here. Imperishably, he says. He says only through great suffering can humanity grow.
Yeah, all I've been writing around here is bloody perishable letters to Mum. Dear Mum, yeah, I'm doing my best to keep me undies clean. Me and my mate Smiler, good as took turkey this morning. We toddled up this hill, Chunuk Bair, and bugger me days if we didn't win the war to end all wars.
You can't say bugger me days to your mum, they'll censor that. They'll think it's some kind of secret message.
Yeah, too right. It means Brigadier General Johnson slapping the Turks again and calling us cowards.
Well, have you got any paper?
What?
Paper?
Time's a sacrifice, Smiler. Back into the bush.
Oh, but they're thorny.
Jesus Christ! You'll want flowers on your grave next. Bloody hell!
What is it?
No one home. Next to no one.
No?
Think. Just some machine gun post over there.
The Abdul's?
More dead than alive. A mate of yours is taking his time over a turd. Shall I give him a yell and see how he's off the paper?
Shut up!
Some other side cooking breakfast. More than we are. Cork of view. Bloody beaut. You can see all the way up the coast. The Dardanelles look like a big, bloody, fat river down there, like the Wanganui.
God, what about that bit? All these months, no one's seen that until us. Jesus. Hey, where's Constantinople?
Over the hills and far away, mate. You reckon we press on and take that too?
I can just about smell their bloody breakfast. How many minutes since we had Tucker?
Real Tucker?
Oh, not bully beef, the colours of the rainbow.
That's it then. That's it. I'm gonna go over there and ambush myself a shish kebab.
Oh, we got to wait. I wonder where they've all gone, all the other actors.
Oh, Navy Yachts. Last night, look at all the legs lying around. They must have been run.
Oh, it could be a trick.
Sly buggers. Looking down into Anzac Cove with their binoculars. Waiting all these months just for Porky and Smiler to trot along. Aha, they say, clear the decks. We're gonna do those two bad bastards from arseholes to breakfast time. Ah, here's half a scrum. G'day, Matt. Come here often.
Oh, don't tell me you bloody don't.
Oh, whenever I got the cow's milk to a Saturday. Too right.
Bloody rabbit country.
Oh, bugger all breed.
You're fighting, mate. Mountaineering. No bloody place for infantry.
Oh, tell General Sir Ian. All we need is cavalry.
Many over
there? Oh, not to write home about.
Come on.
There's a few with a machine gun.
Yo,
with a machine gun.
All the rest smelled Smiler coming, shouted Imshiala and took off home.
I reckon it could be a trap.
You see the Dardanelles?
Oh, pretty as a picture.
Christ. Jesus Christ.
Speak of the devil.
Hey, Holly. Come to give us a sermon on the mount.
Mate, shut up, you bastard.
Ah, that proves it. Gallipoli is no place for a Bible class teacher.
God, it looks better than a winning scoreboard at full time. We could be home at homes. And what happened to Nobby?
Oh, he's just having a quiet patch.
He's dead too.
Yeah, started practicing for it yesterday. Didn't want to talk. You ask me, he was fairly bloody rude. Hey, it's not catching. If you don't want to sling your hook, talk about the weather.
Or where the hell Colonel Connolly is.
Yeah, or Sergeant Frank.
Yeah, they're coming.
So's Christmas, and I don't believe in virgin birth.
Well, the sergeant's still getting me around the apex. I think he's found some more Turks.
Poor sods. Yeah, nothing like New Zealand sheep shagger telling them they're offside.
Connolly makes me glad I'm not salt and sack. The rest of the time, I bloody wonder.
Didn't see much of Sergeant Frank after the boat attention.
Oh, he'll be alright. He's got a reputation for it, hasn't he?
For what?
Not getting killed.
Oh, bloody rubbish! All of us have got a reputation for not being killed. So we are.
Then you've got to have faith, don't you?
Well, what would you know about faith?
I know about Sergeant Frank. When we were at Quinn's, blokes used to say, stay close to Frank, mate. When an ambulance chucked a bomb at our Dixie T, Frank just threw his coat over it. We all threw ourselves over Frank. He wasn't going to get killed.
Yeah, not under all your heaving asses.
Oh, we're staying close to him. We were lucky.
Dipping out on tea's not bloody lucky.
Oh, Frank flogged another Dixie. Union rules, tea on time. Frank's very particular.
He's bloody particular about this big brother.
He tries to get us all through, not just young Fred.
Yeah, there are other sergeants who don't get killed.
Yeah, they get their men do it for them.
We ought to give it a go.
Give what a go?
That machine gun post.
Jesus, who let you loose?
Oh, we'd piss him. Give him the heat blow before the others come. Who's game? Holy?
He's turning the other cheek.
Come on, Smiler, let's blow the whistle on them.
Smiler doesn't do anything he can't eat.
Yeah, no use asking you.
Oh, don't want to get killed in the rush, mate.
Fuck you too.
All that was months
We're
back.
Still got a war going.
Now you tell us. If you had the brains to go with your box, you'd be bloody brilliant.
Should have been up here yesterday.
Brigadier General Johnson needed a skinful of Scotch courage before he made Chunuk Bair safe for the British Empire. I'm exercising tactical judgment too. Smile, game of poker?
I reckon those engines are ready to call it a day.
Oh, if you like that sort of thing, I hear they're buggers for it.
Yeah, we can't take you anywhere.
Dear Mum. Mac was the bastard who played footy for Wellington. The one the ref always sent off. Holly, you wouldn't want to know about, but I'd better be honest about the horrors of war.
Shut up for Christ's sake.
Whose?
Christ's.
Bloody blasphemy it's come to now. I liked you better when you were a Bible basher. You wouldn't say shit, even if your mouth was full of it.
Oh, Porky, have a heart.
Nobby and Holly, they know there's no rest for the wicked. That right, Holly?
I'm learning.
Anyway, only Allah knows the ins and outs of a duck's ass around here.
Yeah, so consider yourself warned.
I'm considering a prayer match to face me. Dawn and sunset, mate. God, I'm dry. Hey, Holly, you haven't had a look over the top yet, have you?
No.
Aren't you gonna have a squiz? It's what we're here for, the Dardanelles.
Look, I'll do what I do and I bloody have to!
When you joined up, didn't you say you heard Christ calling you? Into what? The great unknown?
Shut up!
Give it a bone, Porky. Put a sock in it or I will.
I'm telling you, the great unknown's just over there. And he's not bloody interested. Can't believe it myself now. Joining up. Biffing a bloke for my place in the queue.
Yeah, I bribed a bloke for mine.
Hey, Nobby, what did you do to join up?
Nobby joined up to see the world.
Well, he's getting a bloody grand tour of the next one.
I thought the war might end too quick.
Yeah, your big chance to put the boot in and be called a hero.
Well, we had to show what we could bloody do.
Then you ought to be as happy as a pig in shit up here. No other bugger's been this high. We go home to Merry Maryland now.
Piker!
I reckon we done our bit by the end.
Says who?
Says Nobby.
He'll tell you the Empire treats horses better.
Go on, ask him.
He'll say home doesn't seem half bad.
I don't remember home being even half bad.
It was bloody quiet.
So that's not bad.
I mean, butter all going off, gold all dug, bush all chopped. We were bloody bored.
Speak for yourself.
Anyway, what does pig sticking abdos prove? That we're just like other buggers.
Better.
Hey, what's going on down there?
Oh, Australians at Lone Pine clearing all room for their two-up skills.
Oh, all that shooting. Better be careful, someone could get killed.
Yeah, I think you're just selling a dummy while we score up here.
Hey, holy. Hear that? God's servants are fighting for righteousness and justice against the power and evil of the unspeakable Turk. Isn't that what you used to say?
One of these days I will! I swear I will!
Do me?
Yeah.
You and who else?
Me!
Yeah. Well, stop me if you haven't heard the one about General Syrian and Shrapnel Gut.
Now only hugs are like a bloody Turk in those.
Brigadier General Johnson's taking General Syrian around the New Zealand Brigade. Uncouth colonial louts, Johnson says to Syrian. But it's a fascinating challenge, making passable Imperial soldiers out of them. Just think, there's an abdomen attack down Shrapnel Gun. A big ballicky bloke from Dunedin takes off in front of them. A very passable soldier. So bloody passable, he passes Johnson and Syria at 50 miles an hour. Why are you running, my good man? They shout. And the big bloke from Dunedin yells, because I can't bloody fly.
Is that
Jesus, Smiler. You must have been the biggest dad in the shearing shed. Go on, crack a grip. It's been 4 months. You're all taking Gallipoli too personally.
It's very bloody personal.
Smiler doesn't mean it's which way wins the war.
You're the bloody expert.
Oh, where are the British?
Oh, making more sense than we are.
We can't take on Turkey by ourselves today.
If you weren't going, Smiley, I shouldn't have joined.
Here they come!
The British!
Now, our mob! Look like all Wellingtons, up that middle gully. Back, forth, look, there's Sergeant Frank.
Oh, thank Christ. There's Fred. Yeah, Frank's getting Fred.
Yeah, he would be.
You'd look after a younger brother.
And Scruffy.
Scruffy? He needs looking after him. If his arse was loose, he'd lose that tone.
You will so bloody complain. Frank's getting in for
it. I can't see them.
You wouldn't see the second coming.
They're not exposing themselves unnecessarily.
Someone just did. Colonel Connolly. Back behind.
Yeah, Connolly doesn't like doing it doggy style. There's that new Agony. What's his name? Harkness.
The new Agony's name's Smythe.
Nah, it's Harkness. Smythe was last week's lieutenant.
That's all very bloody confusing.
Oh hell, Harkness is a very different name from Smythe.
Smiler means, once they've finished saluting the Christ out of Connolly, they've been sent home in a jam jar.
Come on, the dead deserve respect.
I treat them with a lot of respect, mate. I find a fair cow to be downwind on a warm day.
Dump them there! Come along, move!
Come on!
True, Sarge.
You sick looking
animals.
Just one machine gun.
That's all. What in Christ do you think you're doing? None of you can organise yourselves a stealer and a brothel. Get that body out!
Come on, it's not me.
I don't care if it's bloody Alibaba. Get him out of the way. Fast. Fred Dutu, get off your ass.
Oh, now you've got breath.
When you bloody ought to. Hurry up, Scruffy.
Christ! So much shit!
Smiler, no sense of decency in battle, mate.
Can't you read them signs, man? Oh, Smiler, you know, cover the earth just after you rise to keep down disease and what is it?
To keep down disease and lessen the flies.
Yeah, flies. Can't you read, Smiler?
This is an Anzac code.
With Smiler around, it'll soon seem like home, Scruff.
Shut up!
They wouldn't leave the summit defended with
just one machine gun. Not after all I've been throwing at us.
Oh, they bloody can't. That's it. That's all. The Darling Elves. Yeah.
Doors. Wide open.
Oh, they can close it quick. I've been having a bash at that already. Back behind.
It could be a trap.
Bloody good as ours. Chunuk Bair. If we want it.
Good question.
I wasn't asking a question.
Why, was? Well, do we? Oh, I'm not getting my tits in a tank.
Why, you've been getting us up here.
Connolly has.
Come on.
He's not going to believe this. All his birthdays at once. Anyone know how to get one good Vickers out of three bugger ones?
Where's the machine gun section, Sarge?
Business elsewhere.
All of them.
We got their guns out.
We're unit, Sarge.
Christ, if that's their guns, I'd hate to see them. Come on! Someone's got to have some idea.
I might.
You scruff.
Jesus. I used to fix the boss's truck. It's harvester too.
There's one boss I feel sorry for.
I'll have it a go.
Freak, you take over from Matt. Put a jerk into it. But Atlas, we're a sparrow bus out there we need tonight. But, now what do you think?
Oh, Christ. Jesus Christ.
I didn't ask for a prick.
I need tools.
Use your imagination.
I bloody need them in a skyhook.
Holly, Scotty, you too, Snowy, give Mac a hand. Just one big gun, that's all we want.
Yeah, tomorrow we walk on water too.
Now here, Mac, you can use my special pocket knife.
You rotten scruff.
Won it from an Aussie when he wasn't looking, did you, scruff?
A border when the war started.
Oh, surprised the other side didn't pack it in then and there.
I thought I might need it to fix stones our horses.
Oh, or wrong war again, eh, mate?
Eh?
The horses.
Oh, mine always been slow.
Look out, he's got trouble.
Legs. Bugger my leg.
Needs attention, sir.
Chunuk Bair needs attention, Harkness. Sergeant, well,
virtually undefended up here.
Easy. Good God, no reinforcement visible.
Just the Darden Owls very bloody visible.
At last.
At last. Just like that.
Well, I wouldn't call 4 months just like that. Or yesterday,
but we've knocked the bastard off.
We've looked up here long enough.
Handsomely earned.
Handsomely is a matter of opinion, which we won't pursue.
I know an order when I hear it.
Sir.
Were you saying something?
The Colonel should hear you say, sir.
The Colonel hears what he needs to hear.
Chunuk Bair, Harkness.
Music. Bloody music. Now, we're going to do this properly, thoroughly. Take a good look, Harkness, and enjoy it. Porky, you go with the lieutenant. Tell Fred to keep his head down.
Not my idea of a battlefield either.
I require your assistance,
Duke. Right, but I shall ask for it.
I just meant they might have things better organised in France.
Well, and you'd know the difference, would you, between good organisation and bad? Sir?
Up here, I find it hard to tell the difference between my ass and my elbow, sir.
Magnificent, sir. One can even imagine Xerxes building his bridge of boats about the Persian warriors out of Asia, sir.
His what?
His, Persian warriors, sir. Out of Asia.
Damn it, Harkness, which war are you in?
It's, difficult to forget here, sir. Troy just over there, there's history everywhere, sir.
What about the Turks, man? How the hell does the summit look?
Sea crossing, sir.
Get your bloody head out! I couldn't stop the silly bugger!
Jesus, that's all we need!
Oh, Turks by the ton!
Stand to, quick, forge that! Could have done us all a favour and lost him back there. He was on the scent of history. History will bloody do us.
Can't see him at all. He's gone into a gully.
I was priding myself that my lieutenants lived longer than the 5-day wonders of other units.
Well, he's going to stuff your figures.
He's coming.
Get on with that. I should tear you up for brass paper.
I was expecting to stop a blast, sir.
Well?
The sergeant's right, sir.
That's never news.
Minimum opposition. Only one potential pocket of resistance to the west of the summit, sir. However...
Thought you might have a hiccup.
From my superior vantage point, sir, superior to the sergeant's, that is, I was able to observe some unoccupied Turk trenches, presumably vacated overnight, halfway between us and our objective. Now, if I might hazard an educated guess, sir.
Education's a great advantage, Harkness. Astonish me.
The Australian diversion down at Lone Pine successfully drawn them downhill, sir.
Splendid. So a right plum to fall, eh?
The summit, sir, yes. The choice is from here to Hill's Point. Chunuk Bair, to heaven to hold.
Are you going to say that, sir? Literally.
We establish ourselves here. Then, with our gallant British brothers, pour down upon the Dardanelles.
I understand that's the approximate plan, sir. Big leave to take appropriate action.
Want to be the first officer to have the Dardanelles at his feet, eh?
It'll be a deathless moment, sir.
Then bloody lifeless. I want more fern leaves along this crest before we try to rush, before we try to hold. When we play our hand, we wait until the dealer has finished.
Expect so, sir.
Not a poker man, I dare say.
No, sir.
Not one for wild women either.
Sir?
Women, for God's sake!
No, not really, sir.
Sweat it all out on a cricket field, eh?
First college, first 11, sir.
Ready to do the Empire proud today.
I trust so, sir.
Even if you're ready, never rush a woman.
Check on when the husband's home.
And little local. I don't want to be bare-arsed out the back door in 5 minutes, strangled by some bloody washing line. I speak from experience, Huggins.
About the washing line, sir?
About the damn husband! Chunuk Bair has one. Most devoted. Mustafa. Mustafa Kemal. A made man if he cleaned dust out of Anzac. He's even tried New Zealanders on with a megaphone. Told us to go home, it wasn't our soil, it wasn't our war.
Damned impertinent, sir! He must know about duty, our devotion to the Empire by now, sir!
He knows about duty, Harkness. His is to chew your balls off!
Understood, sir.
Not yet, you don't, Harkness. He doesn't order his men to attack. He orders them to die!
Pass me that pin, scrub. Oh, don't wipe your bloody nose for this one, man. Oh, shut up!
When I require your help, Harkness, I ask for it. Order it! Understood?
You try, sir.
I've been losing interest.
Sir?
Trying to keep men alive in a dunghill isn't my idea of war. Now we can bloody breathe again. Now get back down there, Harkness.
Done, sir.
Scout around. See what the hell is happening to the rest of New Zealand. Canterbury should be near. Auckland and Otago not far behind. Give them the good news. Hurry the lazy buggers up. Sergeant, you scout around the crest. See how much we can pull out.
He always like this.
You'll learn. Think I'm not up to it, don't you? I don't think. I know.
I intend to get respect from your men, sir.
You'll be lucky, mate. Aren't you Sergeant South's younger brother?
That's right.
Borough Fred South, sir. A lot to live up to.
Frank's all right.
Where have you been?
Hospital, sir. Alexandria. Got taken off the day of the landing. Right on the metro April 25th. Then a ship came.
I had a lucky one.
Yeah, here to me.
Sniped first time out, eh?
Not exactly, sir. Accident.
Accident?
We were just up.
Why do you say accident?
We were stuck just off of the beach.
Bodies everywhere. Brokes were expecting to get taken off again. They were saying it was the wrong beach.
And the wrong war, no doubt. The wrong generals.
Things like that. There was all the shouting and shooting. Frank was cleaning muck out of his rifle. Didn't notice the shot up his spout.
Notice the sergeant.
The fire hadn't moved the moment Frank's gun went off, I'd have lost all my kneecap.
And been off Gallipoli altogether. Back home with a convincing limb.
I got gangrene. It was just about as bad in Alexandria. Hardly any doctors. Most dying.
Never mind. Back to the big show, eh?
Just in time, sir.
And I trust you now pay due attention when your brother chooses to clean his rifle.
Always now, sir.
So what, Private Fred South, do you think of the view?
It's great, sir. The Dardanelles down there, it's just great, sir.
Noble. Damn noble.
Expect you could say that, sir.
Chunuk Bair enough to make you love war, eh?
You feel good, sir. Getting up here, know you can do it.
Good lad, of course you can.
Oh, bloody boss is bulletless in the mirror again.
What do you mean, man?
Yeah, he thinks he's king of the castle.
No, not that way. You've got it all wrong.
Shut up.
But I only said...
And I said shut up. Who's bloody doing this?
Sergeant, how's it looking?
Clean as a whistle. Just the ones you see.
Help him, for Christ's sake. Help him.
There. That's it. We better have a look at that, Len.
Pass me that breech block there. No, not that one, the other one.
But this one's better.
Shut up.
Just a moment. Strip his trouser leg bit. Take a look. It's only in there. Where's Harkness? Christ knows. He should be back.
He felt like still bloody poor.
There's a bullet.
Nonsense.
Honest, sir. Not far in. Back of your calf muscle. Must have been near the end of its tether. The bullet, I mean.
Long range.
God damn it.
Not too deep.
Lucky one, not mine.
Do you intend to conduct a conversation with a damn thing or get it out?
Just like that?
Just like that. Get it bloody out!
You heard it, Colonel! Get the bloody thing out!
There. That way, Mac. Now work the rest in.
But that's wrong too, Sarge.
Shut up! That way, Mac. Get on with it. Are you still buggerizing about?
I'm trying.
Jesus, you're pushing in deeper. You're all bloody thumb.
I didn't join up to be a nurse.
You didn't join up to be anything much, did you?
Give me a chance.
I did. You bloody missed it. Get back there again.
You missed it, as I understand it, Sergeant.
I was talking about his joining up.
Cleaning your rifle, were you?
Oh! Never mind.
There. That's got the bastard.
Oh, that's better. Hang on. It needs bandaging. Strap it.
News isn't good.
When is it ever?
2,000 Australians dead at Lone Pine. At the neck, 500 went at the Turk trenches. Perhaps a couple of dozen lived. Men in the third wave knew there was no hope at all. Stunning sight, I get it.
You like that sort of thing? Didn't think you did.
They'll sing songs about Lone Pine in the neck one day.
Silly buggers.
Don't despise courage.
What about common sense?
Who sings about that?
I've heard you having a shout about it.
What makes a hero, Sergeant?
I wouldn't know.
The voice of experience. A coward, what makes him? Gonna tell me you wouldn't know again?
It's all I do bloody know.
Up from the beach on April 25th, eh? The panic of landing and wanting to get off again? And wanting to get others off again?
I was thinking of somewhere else.
Well, I was thinking of youngsters pissing with fright. They have to learn, Sergeant. Otherwise they have to live with it. With disgust.
I was out sniping in June. Watched these two Turks for an hour. Harmless little sods. One was cooking scraps of wood. The other washing and pegging out clothes.
So you didn't shoot them? And that was cowardice?
I did. And that was. And that's what I bloody live with! Hey, how's that gun?
Oh, still arguing a toss.
Hey, Mick.
Shut up.
How's it up there?
Quiet. Too bloody quiet.
Yeah, bring on the dancing girls.
Where's Harkness?
Could be catching common sense.
Let Harkness make his own case, Sergeant. You junior officers are in a damnable position.
Shouldn't bloody send them. Shouldn't bloody send anyone.
It wouldn't surprise me if you flew the red flag back home.
You've got no surprise coming.
Only a couple of years since I was clobbering you, buggers.
You'd have been a good Cossack, Captain.
Christ, man, easy! Can't even remember. What were you striking for? What did you want?
Me. For Prime Minister!
I thought you lot were campaigning against the war anyway. All capitalist conspiracy.
Imperialist! I don't need a lecture! Try and meet Friday night's trade hall.
If you lot are against the war, why the hell are you here?
Not enough of a hero to stay home.
Come on, man, what are you doing here?
That's my business. Being Sergeant don't damn well make it mine!
Oh, Jesus, Porky, you complain about me.
What is it now?
You farting like a train.
It's a poor ass that never rejoices, old son. And a poor soldier who can't stand his cobber's breath.
Give me that bolt, Scrub.
No, not that one, the other one.
But this one's better.
Shut up. Man. I tell you, I'll bring you one.
Just something I've been meaning to ask.
Oh, well, ask, mate.
I mean, where are we?
Bloody hell, Scruff, not again. You tell him, Polly, your turn, this one.
It's like this, Scruff. Gallipoli's the kind of backside of Europe.
Oh, the Arsene.
Yeah, and Chunuk Bair's half up. Yeah. Over there's Asia, see? Another part of the world, just across that bit of sea.
I don't see why it's another part of the world. It looks just the same, bit of sea between.
That's it, Scruff. Just a bit of sea. Over between these hills, between Europe and Asia. We need it.
A bit of water. Who'd want that?
Britain does. The motherland. Then we can take Constantinople.
How far is that?
About 199 miles.
Hmm. How far have we come?
About a mile.
Yeah, that's about what I thought.
Well, once we've got Constantinople, then we can take Russia.
Russia?
Well, it's like Turkey. Part of Europe, part of Asia, only it's on our side.
So, Arthur and Martha around here, not like home.
You just think about hills, Scruff. You know about hills.
Yeah, you go up and down, like on a mustard.
Yeah, and we got up this one, didn't we, Scruff?
Yeah, I think you two are trying to tell me something.
Yeah, there's a war on.
Yeah, that's about the size of it, mate.
You haven't changed your mind about that commission.
I said no.
Your officer material man.
Next thing you tell me, responsibility works wonders with rebels. Hasn't worked too many with you.
No?
You make more trouble than any colonel round Anzac. There isn't an English officer who doesn't hate your guts.
That's professionalism, not rebellion.
You could have fooled me.
Everyone all the way to the top should know how to fight a war too.
Lost cause.
We were talking about you refusing a commission.
I don't fancy dead men's shoes.
Or leaving your brother with more than one leg to stand on.
Where in Christ's name have you been?
Sorry, sir. Put down.
Put yourself together, man.
It's the truth, sir. The way we climbed the rock, the way we came in the dark. It's impossible now, sir. There's hellish crossfire. The Turks blast every bush that moves.
Canterbury?
No signs, sir.
Otago, Auckland?
No New Zealanders at all, sir.
God damn it.
They'll never get through now, sir.
So no more Fernley. We've had the ladder kicked out from under our feet.
In effect, sir.
What does that suggest to you, Harkness?
That the British had better be quick in bringing up our left flank, sir.
It suggests to me that Wellington had better be pretty bloody good today.
Indeed, sir.
Are you still mucking about?
Oh, we're doing our best, sir.
Today, mate, we do better than our bloody best.
Mac, shut up.
The sergeant says that most of the crest is still as quiet as it looks. Just that one machine gun post, and on the summit, those trenches. What do you think?
We establish ourselves on the summit, and then wait for the British to bring up their big guns.
Good.
Then we'll see who's master of the Dardanelles. Turkey will be left reeling, sir.
Very good.
We'll have Russia safe, Germany pleading for mercy, the war over by the end of 1915, sir.
Excellent.
Up there our prospects seem quite splendid. Remarkably good.
Well, if you've won the war, Harkness, perhaps we can contemplate those trenches.
Yes, sir.
We're going to be remarkably and quite splendidly buggered if we don't get one machine gun working.
Do you allow this, sir?
Allow what?
Sergeant, non-commissioned men, to interrupt.
Since I make it my duty to jog the imagination of my commanding officers, I don't deny the sergeant the point of view.
If you say so, sir.
I do say so. If there's no speaking up, men die. What's the Imperial Army, do you?
Sir, I thought on Gallipoli we were all of the Imperial Army.
Well, this, Harkness, is the Wellington Infantry Battalion of the New Zealand Infantry Brigade.
Yes, sir.
Something else on your mind, Sergeant?
Water.
We're all running dry.
In this heat.
Then we'll drink our piss. Water won't win Chunuk Bair.
We could bloody lose it. Another thing. Could be a trap out there on the summit.
May I speak, sir? This man is a defeatist. Even if I may say so, a shirker.
That will be all, Harkness. You may not say so. Not of any man in my battalion. Think I'm difficult, do you? That's what you've been told?
More or less, sir.
More or less?
More, sir. Often, in fact. I was told that you're very difficult.
Better. Give me some more good news.
They say you're, well, rather possessive.
What's left of them?
Yes, sir.
So I'm not just rather possessive, Harkness. I'm very possessive. Understood?
I shall try, sir.
You'd better.
Yes, sir.
They've earned today's outing. Before we came to Gallipoli, I gave them hell. No mercy ever. The longest route march is the toughest punishment. Hell! They give you the horrors, Harkness?
They're not pretty, sir.
They give me nightmares too. God knows what they give the enemy. I bash bloody pride into them. They know who they are. No one else could have barged up here, only the best.
The best, sir.
Ask the Turks. They close up their loopholes, batten down the hatches, shut up shop when we're in the next trenches.
Sergeant, even if it isn't a trap out there, it might as well be. No Australians on the right, no British on the left.
What does that add up to?
Us being here.
Exactly.
We're getting done again. Fire from both flanks. Hill Q that way, Battleship Hill the other. Abdul's all over.
Good, we won't die of boredom. I trust you've been observing the activity down there in Sivla Vale.
Well, we've been taking an interest.
20,000 fresh Britons have landed so far. They're not sick, they're not starving. They're bracing to push up here, they'll be our left flank.
They've been bracing a long time.
There may be more to it than meets the eye.
Oh, General Sir Ian Hamilton. He'd make Shit Street smell of roses.
Shall I make an arrest now, sir?
Arrest whom, Harkness?
That sergeant, sir. Citizen in the line.
How is it?
Oh, something's still sticking.
Mick won't listen.
Shut up.
I'm serious, sir. I said sedition.
Think our brigade is rotten with it, do you?
It's as if the men... It's almost as if they're not really British, sir.
Oh, congratulations, Harkness. Q keen perception. Now, for Christ's sake, make yourself useful.
Useful, sir?
Take another quick look downhill. Anything. Sergeant, your recipe.
Make yourself scarce. Get off.
Oh, off Chunuk Bair.
Better now than later.
Perhaps you should have taken Harkness more seriously.
It's not worth it.
We're going to make Chunuk Bair worth it. That, Sergeant, is an order.
Well? A few to work their way around the crest with me. The others can rush those empty trenches as a diversion. Only as far as the empty trenches. While they keep the machine gunners fascinated, we'll be in for our chop. We'll take the crew from the rear.
Good, very good.
We'll have to be.
Something troubling you?
Grenades. We can take them out quick with grenades.
The British War Cabinet thinks otherwise.
They think we take out Turks with pins stuck in maps.
Anything else?
That machine gun. Whoever moves into those trenches is going to need it.
We can't wait.
You think we could do anything,
can't we?
We can't hold the summit. Not alone.
Then think of those 20,000 fresh Britons.
Swarming up here.
Another 20,000 promises.
Bloody terrorists! Ambush!
Yes. Chunuk Bair, mate. End of the line. All passengers change.
Keep your bloody eyes open.
Where in damnation did you spring from?
OTPA.
This is not the Murray Battalion. This is the Wellington Infantry.
Could be worse, sir.
You've no combat duty. You're a pioneer man, your lot. You're deserting duties elsewhere.
Looks like it, eh?
Well, where were you when this attack began?
On the end of the shovel, boss. Swinging on the old banjo. Just up from the beach, down in Charlotte Dera. The boss said, now you dugout Lantern King, you get on digging Manor Street through to Courtney Place.
So where is it now, your shovel?
Took a walk, eh?
You mean you took a walk?
No, I couldn't find it up to smoke, huh? I thought, bugger.
You thought, bugger.
Bugger Manor Street. Bugger Courtney Place. There were these judges from Otago going past. Made room for a sunburned pakeha.
Otago, where are they now?
Bush back and road in Edinburgh. I shot through, eh? Found some judges from Canterbury. Then a mate of mine from Auckland. How's that, eh? All about the country in an hour.
Tell you something, though.
They're going round and round back there, too.
It's bad, then.
Pretty crook.
Well, how did you get up here?
No one said I couldn't. Only some abdos, poor buggers. Looks like I'm here now. Still haven't found the bugger.
Found who?
The bugger who robbed my shovel.
Your lot have been out of harm's reach for your own good.
You're good digging your roads.
I wasn't saying that.
Sounded like it.
We're still brothers in arms.
Hello, brother. Where's the arms? Never mind. Brought mine. I think you buggers are still frightened I was pointing them at you.
This is a real war, a thing of nations.
Those abdos back there must have got a fright when this nation did it. So that's it, eh? Some brothers to walk the roads, some brothers to dig them. Guess which were the brown brothers?
Still no one coming, sir.
We've just had a great account. It seems Otak in here is the last building to unfurl on Chunuk Bair.
So that's it, sir. Until the British, mate.
Fern leaves. Watch that, Chris. You others on your feet. I know you've had a gutful. I know you're beat to the teeth with a few filthy acres of turkey. And I know you said goodbye to too many mates. But I know, bloody know you can do more.
We got a choice.
Today you make sure those mates are remembered. Today you give them Chunuk Bair. Yes, I know, on an August weekend, we'd sooner be watching the Wellington team hang on to the Ranfurly Shield. And McDonald here would be heaving his heart out right in the middle of the Wellington scrum.
Yeah, I'd be trying.
Especially on the Auckland.
Or on Otago's.
Jesus! Is that wild joke to play footy for Wellington?
Sure is, mate.
The last minute of the game.
Wellington, still 2 points down. What's the story, McDonald?
Guts for Gardenstein.
It's been a hickledy-pickledy sort of show so far.
You can say that a bloody game.
You say something quite true.
Not fit for mixed company, sir.
All right, it's been a bloody disgrace so far. How's that? All forwards. No backs. And nobody knows where the bloody ball is. You'd like to say something, McDonald?
Why don't we have our own bloody generals?
Because, McDonald, we might be cheeky enough to fight our own wars. Next question. All right. We've got brawling Australians playing their own game, somewhere out on the right wing. Shy Britons waiting to get the game on the left. But we've done it. They thought we were nothing.
odds and sods, miners, farmers, shearers, bushmen, navvies.
And musteries, sir.
And musteries. And now the Turks say that New Zealanders are even more terrible than the Bulgars.
We bloody are.
We know who we are. Fern leaves. And we're going to go on now. Remind us of the date, Harkness.
August the 8th, sir.
August the 8th. 1915. Today's the day we got out from under.
Not a general in sight.
Good. Not an ally up here. Good.
Chunuk Bair is our show.
Good.
We do it ourselves. Believe in ourselves.
If anyone is going to win anything out of this war, we are.
What's the story, McDonald?
Guts for Garden's time to get their bloody hooker.
Sergeant, get your party together. Ready to move.
Forky. Snow, you too, Mac.
Me? What about this?
I need you, mate. Leave it with Scrub.
Oh, he'll end up with a pea shooter.
Don't worry, Mac. I'll give him the hand. What about me? I'm Nazi Toa.
You telling me something?
Nazi Toa's to Rapa, that's right.
Ti Rapa, right? There by God was a warrior.
Nazi Toa was a funny twilight, but no bugger ever stopped there. Even that wire out, when you tried stealing our land, we leave Jewel dead.
Sergeant? Alright, you too. But I do the talking from now on.
To the boss, right?
That's enough. Christ. Any more, we'll be tripping over each other.
Sergeant, this boy stands on two good legs.
Does that mean I can go?
Release a foot, are you?
Fairly, sir. But lad, I need a runner.
Sure.
I didn't hear that.
No, sir.
We'll soon be up to our next mate. That's a promise.
Yes, sir.
Harkness, you'll take a sprint to those trenches. Your business is to draw fire, not to win a posthumous Victoria Cross. Keep it safe, you're just a diversion.
A diversion, sir.
To let Sergeant South get on with it. Anyone want pub ships? Do it now!
I'm saving mine for a birthday treat.
Better save for the water cooler when I get this gun working.
Oak springs bloody eternal.
Cutlery!
Eh?
The thing that goes with a fork!
You'll have 5 minutes to get into position.
Five. Then Harkness makes his run for those trenches. You move in.
5 minutes.
It'll pass.
Prisoners,
don't do anything I wouldn't do. A lively day, I am.
Yes, sir, until the British make it.
Liveware if they don't.
Well, if they won't leave us in the lurch, sir. They can't.
Can't?
They wouldn't be able to forgive themselves, sir.
Desirably, Harkness.
It would, make rather a mockery of, well, of everything, sir.
Not been in with a bayonet yet, have you?
Only in drills.
Forget Imperial drill. We don't fend with it. We boot them in the balls, bash them with the butt, then slash into them. One tip. Don't worry about what comes out with it. Bloody encourage it. Don't linger. Slash into the next one. Watch the sergeant. We're damn fine killers. We're bred to it. Hunters, farmers, slaughtermen. Don't let the side down.
No, sir.
Love your own country.
My country, sir?
I presume we have more than merely the empire in common.
Merely the empire, sir?
Your country, damn it, Harkness. Love it?
Oh, of course, sir. One does.
One does.
Well, the truth is I haven't really had much time to think about it, sir. School, university, my father's office, and I would have been off home for a bit this year, but for
home?
Great Britain, sir.
Oh, pity.
Yes, I should have liked to have seen the old country.
No, I'm in a pity you don't know your own. Sheep crossing the hills on a misty summer morning mean nothing to you, eh? Or a hot pool amongst fern at the end of a long day's ride?
Regrettably, not much, sir.
3 minutes?
Yes, almost, sir.
Oh, a fine instrument.
Yes, sir. My father presented it to me the day we embarked. The men on the ship called me Old Wristwatch. Not every officer had one.
My father Harkness wouldn't present me with more than a well-placed boot in the backside, especially if I was slow slashing through an acre of bush before breakfast.
A difficult man, sir.
A New Zealander, Harkness. A bloody-minded bastard. A bog Irishman who built himself from the bootstraps up and knew why. He had soil he could call his own, a country. Didn't let me forget it.
I think I understand.
You do? Well, I bloody didn't. I never understood what the hairy old bugger was on about, not until now. 2 minutes?
Yes, sir, precisely 2 minutes.
Turks!
Right,
out!
Two of them walking this way!
They could foul it all up.
Alright.
They're just ready a couple of bodies for smoke. Just like we do.
They're lining up.
Done.
You'll get your chance, Harkness. In sight of Troy.
Yes, it's difficult to imagine Achilles and Hector just crouched, hiding.
Then imagine T. Ralph Raha. Cunning old devil, deadly in ambush, never said die.
Don't know much about him, sir.
Pity, Harkness, pity.
So I expect so, sir.
Clear again, Professor.
They're walking back to the gun. Clear, sir.
I'm not a sentimental man, Harkness. Couldn't write a poem for the life of me, or paint a picture. But I'd like to have something to show for this barnyard of a war.
The Dardanelles, sir.
Damn the Dardanelles. Let's see what we can do with Chunuk Bair. No poem, no painting, just a scrubby lump of rock and dirt in nowhere. 1 minute?
1 minute.
Right, Sergeant South should be in position by now.
You there, you two, you and you. Stand to it.
Private South.
Yes, sir.
You know where your place is here.
Bloody hell, sir, my brother.
Time is Harkness.
To the second, sir.
Keep it safe, into those trenches and down. The rest is the sergeant's, his show.
One thing, sir, that machine gun.
Don't worry, she'll be right.
Best bit's confidence you'll get. If you can't be good, don't be bloody silly.
Ready, man?
Closer, boy, closer. Get comfortable, that's it.
Man,
now!
What's the man doing? Where is your ass on the ground? Down, right, back down!
Where's your showing? Someone's leaving something out.
Where's the attack, the bloody attack? Your brother!
There they are, Miss Frank!
Good man! Good man!
Everyone's away!
He's to stay with those trenches!
Alright!
When you're bloody told to!
Harkness! Harkness!
There he goes! Another gutter!
Never mind! They've done it! We've done it! We've bloody done it!
He's still trying to be everywhere at once!
Harkness?
Now he's very man here! Here he comes!
Thanks for report, sir. Someone of Chunuk Bair cleared an enemy.
Immortal, are we, Harkness?
Most satisfactorily, sir. Losses? Only one man barely hit, sir.
Then in God's name, get him back here. The sergeant thorough.
It's extremely thorough, sir. No prisoners.
Well, time you bloody were. When I told you to take those trenches, I meant for you to hold them. Not flit around like a Chunuk Bair butterfly.
Yes.
Aside from this crest, those trenches are all we have for shelter.
Trenches are shallow, sir.
Dig in.
Almost solid rock, sir.
Then heave out all those dead Turks. Make a wall, get in behind and keep your asses down. The sergeant will report back here with his men and we'll divide our strength. Half out there with you, half here, second line.
Sir, with respect, that provides little opportunity for further offensive action.
That, Marcus, is Mustafa Kemal blowing our raspberry. We have no further offensive action. It's all holding now, holding the door wide for Britain. Now get back out to your men and damn well look after them.
Sir, one thing, that machine gun, sir.
The Turk one no good to you?
Jammed impossibly, sir. They were low on water, too.
Low?
None, sir.
Damn. Well, we'll get this gun out to you. Go, man, go! Sometimes I wonder if Achilles and Hector weren't silly young pricks, too.
Pardon, Colonel?
Was it hard, Achilles? So very hard to die? Thou knowest, and I know not, so much the happier I. We'll keep them happy, won't we? Ignorant and happy.
Yes, sir, if you say so.
Join up after your brother, did you?
I joined up first.
You first?
It was a hell of a run, though. Frank called me a bloody young fool. Dad shouted, mum cried.
What was the problem? Apple of the family eye and khaki?
I don't understand, sir. All my mates were joining.
Oh, of course.
Frank joined up next day too. Still a mystery to me. After calling me a bloody young fool.
Well, that explains it.
Sir?
Because you didn't have more brothers to invigorate. More like Sergeant South.
You never thanked me, sir.
Who the hell are you?
Corporal Batten. Cyril Batten. Divisional Squad.
I thought it was impossible to get up here.
It is, sir, fairly.
Well, how did you do it?
I just sort of kept going, sir. The worse it got, the harder it was to go back.
Who let you into the army anyway?
No one especially, sir. First time I fell because of my chest measurement. Second time as well. I just kept running around joining the queue. Third time nothing. The doctor was drunk and the measuring tape was lost.
And signals weren't so fast?
I can run a telephone in anywhere, sir.
Well, who said I bloody wanted one?
Search me. I just do my job.
I'll have English generals on my back again.
I never get thanks.
I want me. Reinforcements.
Not well-bred fleas in my ear. Not plummy apologies. Where's Canterbury?
Minced up back in rhododendron. Just lying around, what's that?
Otago?
Still stuck.
Auckland?
Big up, too. Can't move up any further.
Well, you bloody did it.
I'm little.
Then we'd all get to learn to be little today.
Answer?
So there's nothing coming up that way. No men, no food, no water.
Oh, I've got a few full canteen. Help yourselves.
What in hell is happening down there in Silver Bay? Where are the British? Fernleys are trying, Australians are dying. Where in Christ are the British?
No one tells me a thing.
Jesus! You failed always with this heart! Hey, Zanzan, come on, seem like the Grand Hotel.
Alright. Where's that water?
They did!
Yeah, he kicked it over. And it doesn't even break his wounded. You all did well!
Only 20 million more to go.
20 million?
Turks!
But we had Chunuk Bair, man.
You know any other funny stories?
I've done it! I've bloody done it!
I've done what, Scruff?
Going together! My gun!
Go on, pull the other one.
My head! My bloody head!
Jesus, save you for a sunbeam.
What?
Yeah, he hears you. What, Captain Scruff?
I've told you I could, Mac. Easier than the boss's harvester.
Boy, that took all day.
Everything that opens and shuts, I've seen everything now.
The first miracle of Chunuk Bair. We need a bloody blizzard of them.
Mac, bring it up here, and the tripod. Swine, Otak, bring the ammo belts too.
I just want to see how I've done it.
Oh, sorry, mate, no time. Sarge wants it.
I'll get it down to Harkis. I want to make bloody sure it gets out there. For some concern, the lieutenant. I want to make sure he stays out there. Doesn't get underfoot again. Let's get the lieutenant's sword and shield out there. Come on, move.
Hey!
What's wrong?
We'll have to piss in the water cooler.
Oh, there goes our afternoon. I'll have to do that out there. Come on, move. Go.
What, what? Chunuk Bair. Blood! Blood!
Who are you trying to get?
General Johnson to start.
Meet Johnson.
Yes, sir. Hello? Hello?
Hello, Mum. Yeah, now you mention it, me and the boys do get a bit farty from now and then. But us lads from down under never get downhearted.
Oh, pay you.
In my own time, mate. Let me finish.
Hello, hello? Someone's coming through now, sir.
I'd like General St. Ian's ear.
General Sir Hamilton's right away out at sea.
He'd lose the bloody battle of Trafalgar too.
Hello, hello? Bassett here. Hello? Bassett here on Chunuk Bair. Chunuk Bair! Yes, mate, do I sound like a bloody Turk? Chunuk Bair! Chunuk bloody Bair!
Starting to get it out there. Bugger that for a game of soldiers.
Chunuk Bair. Message from Brigadier General Johnson, sir.
Water on the way, the British?
He wishes to know your situation.
Intrigue.
Intriguing, sir.
And exhilaration. And bloody diabolical.
Well, that's it.
Say we have our foot on the door. No. Say we're ready to boot the ball right between the posts. Say we've seen the Dardanelles if anyone's interested.
Interested, sir?
Someone better be. Britain bloody better be.
Yes, sir.
Say we have the war by the throat, history by the balls. Tell them some scarecrows called Wellington Infantry have taken Chunuk Bair. No, goddammit. Tell them New Zealand has taken Chunuk Bair. Tell them New Zealand is holding Chunuk Bair. I'll give me the damn thing, I'll tell them myself.
You can't, sir.
Can't.
Right, sir.
I don't think I was meant to be a hero.
Too late to think of it now, old son.
Thank you.
too.
What's up that way?
Troy, Sergeant, best view we've had.
All right for some.
I once read about this archaeologist chap, Schliemann. He read Homer when he was young, and he thought it might all be true, Troy, the Trojan Wars. So he took bearings from Homer, and he dug up a junkyard over there. It was all true, by God, perhaps even Achilles and Hector. They're all bloody Chunuk Bair. Imagine some Eskimo archaeologist 4,000 years from now, digging here and finding a barbarian tribe from the Pacific really did fight a war here. He's going to drive disbelieving Eskimos out of their minds. Private South, Lieutenant Harkness still burgling the shop?
Looks like it, sir.
No Turks on the ground yet?
Not yet, sir.
Of course, there is always another possibility.
That pigs fly and the British come.
No, that our Eskimo friend gets our two towers confused. Troy's, ours.
Tell Harkness to make his day.
Damn it, man, who's forced the gate?
I know who's bloody shutting it.
Private South, it's getting worse out there, sir.
Good, got them
rattled, have we?
Rattled,
sir?
The Turks, boy! See? Tired, Tudor. They're using up ammunition wildly. They're as good as finished.
I guess you could look at it that way, sir.
Always look at it that way.
Yes, sir. Those Turks must be in a terrible panic.
We shall have to hope Lieutenant Harkness doesn't do the rest of us out of a job. Or our allies.
What allies?
Tell me what you see.
What do you expect me to see?
20,000 Britons.
They're just strolling about, sunbathing, brewing up bloody tea.
That's what I thought I saw.
And swimming.
My God, I missed that.
Not a movement up this way. Not a whisper.
What the hell is Hamilton up to?
Composing his memoirs, a rather simple view of things.
Well, just that simple view of things in silver black. Perhaps the British War Cabinet's changing its mind again, deciding it can do without the Dardanelles.
They've always been at sixes and sevens.
Well, some make millions.
Enough in the trade tool now.
All right, so we're up here while British politicians pick their noses.
Perhaps.
Perhaps. First we get along with our grenades. Now we get along with our thing.
I take it you're telling me something, Sergeant.
We're being bloody deserted.
Betrayed. You said it, not me.
That's right, Sergeant. I said it, not you. Bloody betrayed.
We queued for this. Cheered for it! Bought it with bells on!
As you were, Sergeant!
Get that.
In order! As you bloody were!
I'm as I was, alright! It's you I wonder about!
Turks!
Private South!
On the ground, on the side of the summit! I can see them now!
They're here!
Harkness holding so far!
Mac, what's going on?
Shooting on a nose, Scruff.
Wouldn't mind.
The British are leaving us up here.
They wouldn't do that to us, would they, Mac?
The generals can do anything to a soldier, Scruff. Except get him in a family way and some of the bugs give that a go.
What I mean is, Mac, New Zealand's little. The turkey, big.
Yeah, that's about the size of it, mate. Hey, holy! Otangi, take a break. Doesn't look from the grandstand.
We may have to pull hard to back. Consolidate here. Good God, you again?
Yeah, sir.
I keep thinking we've seen the last of you.
Me too, sir.
How many times have you gone back down there now?
Well, I have to count, sir.
That line is still no use.
It's all a shrapnel.
Still bad back there.
Worse.
It's unreasonable, man.
Unreasonable, sir.
It's bloody devotion.
It's my job, sir.
I think you're trying to be a hero. Come on, right up.
Well, I say.
What else is it then?
Well, I mean, what's the use of a job unless you take an interest?
Carry on, Corporal Bassett.
Hello, hello? Bassett here. Chunuk Bair again. Hello? Bassett here. Chunuk Bair.
Trying to get Brigadier General Johnson's staff again?
Yes, sir.
Say water first, water.
Oh, fill my canteen again. Some Auckland blokes done for you. Yeah. Someone coming through now, sir. Hello, hello? Bassett here. Hello? Bassett, I'm Chunuk Bair. Chunuk Bair! Yes, mate, do I sound like a bloody Turk? Chunuk Bair! Hey, look, these blokes are fresh out of water. Yes, mate, water! W-A-T-E-R, the wet stuff. W-E-T! Yes, mate, so are you.
What?
Special message from General Serena Johnson, sir.
Special?
That's what they say.
Private South.
Yes, sir.
While Corporal Bassett here copies out the latest
comic cut, someone's from Erin Run.
Feeling fit, lad.
Feeling, sir.
If we ever get off this hill, we're going to sit around yarning at reunions for years, pretending we were brave. Know exactly what I mean, don't you?
I think so, sir. Yes, sir.
Well, now's your chance to enjoy being scared.
Sir?
A man who can't is only half alive. He's never lived. Now get out there to Lieutenant Harkness. Go like the clappers. See how things stand out there? Then back here smartly.
Look, I'll go.
He's my runner, as I understand. It's your brother, my runner. Then think out there. Harkness has been hurt. Someone will have to take command and pull the others back. I made that decision, Sergeant.
All the same.
Message? All the same, all right. Bunker, then, all the same, you probably are. If Lieutenant Harkness... Never mind, I want to know their situation, and I decide!
It's only Greta and Jules are in Hamilton themselves.
Hamilton?
Themselves.
What brings this on?
Chunuk Bair, I'd say, sir. Do you want me to read it?
Anything to pass an idle hour.
General Sir Ian Hamilton regrets that thus far the offensive has failed to take Achibaba or Koja Tamantepe, but he rejoices in the shining triumph achieved upon Chunuk Bair by... Oh, I'm sorry, sir. You aren't going to like this.
Go on.
By the magnificent Australians.
The what? The who?
By the Australians, sir. The magnificent Australians.
What Australians? Where?
He doesn't seem to know it's New Zealand up here, sir.
Well, as long as he's got someone getting done.
Do you want me to check, sir? See if there's been a correction?
No. Good for us. It'll make us try harder.
Harder, sir?
We'll make our own bloody correction.
He says in humanity's huge hour of trial, the British Empire's audacious feat of arms upon Chunuk Bair has been a tonic.
Whose?
The Empire's, sir. The British Empire's audacious feat of arms.
In your considered opinion, Corporal Bassett, does it get any worse?
Hard to say, sir. He says where so much is dark, where so many are discouraged, he feels both light and joy. He is uplifted, ennobled. Chunuk Bair, he says, will do.
Will do. Will bloody do.
Will do.
Nothing about uplifting and ennobling his 20,000 fellow countrymen in Suvla Bay, getting his brother British generals off their asses.
No mention of asses at all, sir. He asks that you continue to strive with the utmost vigour and fury and an utter disregard of life. Chunuk Bair, he says, must be held to the last man if need be.
To the last, firmly.
He asks, have you got colours, flags, a Union Jack to make a bold show?
To help Turkish gunners find our range.
And a band to keep the spirits up.
A what?
A band. A musical band. Rum ta ta rum ta. He asks, have you got... Oh, I beg your pardon, sir. He says that God is cleaning our celestial star bright with the blood of his bravest and best.
God?
Duty, sir. He asks that you remember that today God is bearing keen witness above.
But the poet for a general who needs colonels.
I've told you, he needs us for his memoirs.
Shut up! I took the submission around here.
Sir.
You signed something.
I said, sir, sir. I could have a salute coming on too.
Get over there. See how much a Chunuk Bair is being scrubbed right.
I want to speak to our revered Brigadier General Johnson if he's finished licking boots.
Hello?
Get me Brigadier General Johnson. We'll tell himself to make himself bloody available. Fast! Bloody fast!
Sir? Connolly here.
What?
Indeed, sir. Indeed, we're bloody well holding on. You'll soon have no colonial louts left to lead. Yes, Fernleys, mate. Not Australians, not Britons, New Zealanders! No, sir, as a matter of bloody fact, I don't see distinctions as invidious within the great imperial cause, not when Britain has thousands of fresh troops basking in the bloody sun. What the hell's happening? We'll ask. Demand!
Yes, I know you're pig in the middle, sir. I just want you to tell Hamilton to get off his elegant bum and go bite it. Listen, sir, I'll tell you who I think I am. I'm a bloody New Zealander. Sir, then, sir, you go bloody bite yours too!
Seems the line's cut again.
Or our diplomatic brigadier has gone back to talking to a bottle.
I'll check, sir. Yeah. Hello? No, not a peep. I'll have to look online again.
You could always crawl back down there and hide in the hole. No one would know.
Inspector could, sir.
You bloody know you could. Come on, you're not going to give me all this bullshit about not wanting to let mates down. You wouldn't give me that, would you?
I'm only giving you the telephone, sir.
You're not even a Wellington.
No, sir, Auckland. Oh, well, in signals. We're just signals.
You've got no Auckland mates up here to know what you did or didn't do. No one to look in the face.
We're all fern leaves, sir.
On our own now.
No one else we can depend on, sir.
Then, Corporal Bassett, spread the word. Spread it far and wide. Carry on. Carry on, Corporal Bassett.
Sir,
what is it now, man?
Well, I mean, good luck, sir.
We know what you mean, Corporal Bassett. You get on with your job, we'll get on with ours. Bad, Sergeant.
Oh, come on. No cover. Trench is jammed.
I told Michael to clear the Turk dead.
Our own now. And wounded. Not your first with the Vickers. Jamming anyway. Fuck all that, mind.
How's Harkness managing?
Not bad.
Sounds like praise from you, Sergeant.
Didn't twist my arm.
And if we pull them back, and the Turk take those trenches again?
Then they'll do us here too. Same thing. No clear field of fire. Grenades.
Let's take another look out there.
Mac, Scruffy, you take a breather.
Mac, I've been thinking serious.
Serious? You, Scruff?
Yeah, me. About fishing. Trout fishing.
I never caught a trout.
Oh, wonders never bloody cease.
I've been thinking things I've never done.
I've been thinking about it, you see.
I think I'll just let help I try.
Catch him by the tongue there. Stuff around with a fishing rod. All the time in the world.
Good time for me too, mate.
I don't mean I don't think serious about this. You know, the war I mean. Oh, I've been working it out.
So, what did you work out?
The guy's got to make a hang of a lot more fern leaves. We don't grow on trees.
What up? Catch a bear.
We might get chained the buggers into coming. That takes the pickled biscuit. Dying to raise an English blush. Let them fight their own bloody fight while we run every man for himself.
Doesn't sound like you.
Never enough now.
Give or take a brother.
The worst thing that can happen to those bastards is getting pensioned off.
Bugger it, man. Can't you see? We're not doing it for them anymore. We're doing it for ourselves.
Ourselves?
Ourselves, us.
I knew you had another funny story.
What a... Jesus,
what? For Christ's sake, someone find him something.
Try blood from a stone.
Get over to Harkness again. Tell him to pull out. Get them back here.
And that's more like it.
I'm the brother.
You'll die where you're bloody told to.
Cover me.
Are you alright?
He's made it to him.
He's crawling now.
Well, I think the sergeant's got it all wrong.
Oh, now what?
General Siri. He can't be a bastard if he never had a mother.
How'd you work that out?
Well, he hatched out when his dad pissed against the wall.
Where the hell is he?
Just go quiet. I could go a mullet, eh? Big bloody mullet.
Wonder what's on General Sirian's menu for lunch.
New Zealand lad.
When I put the net out, sometimes kawai day, eh? Sometimes a flounder day. But the mullet days, they're the best. You just make a fire and cook them on a stick. Sit around till after dark. Bit of beer, bit of sing song, eh?
Don't anyone mention oysters.
Bluff oysters.
Bluff oysters. Big and fat. Big and fat. Straight off the ship.
Fried in the fat.
Quit it, Smiley, and you'll drive a man mad.
It's like looking from Kai Kokoriki Hill up here, eh? You know, like the coast goes up to Otaki.
Nah, I reckon it's more like looking around Cape Kidnappers.
No, I reckon more like Palace of Bay. Past the Lake Mary Park. There once when I was swagging it around the Wairarapa.
I reckon
you're all off your saucer.
You think you made it?
You must have.
Yes, there he goes! Made it!
Good. Stand to every man who can hold a rifle along this crest. Covering fire when Lieutenant Harkness and the Sergeant come back.
Dear Mum, war's a bastard.
Dear son, so are you.
What?
Steady, here they come, now!
Oh, you hit them, here they come!
See,
He never gets killed. God will bound him being followed.
Where are the others? God help me.
Others killed on the way.
Saved you?
Yes, sir.
Couldn't waste you, mate.
The beggars.
Bang. You've done rather splendidly, Lieutenant.
Thanks for me. They won't give up. Even the badly wounded. They refuse to cry out, so we snarled a word for it, sir.
Heroes. Whoever loved a land without them, eh?
Sir.
Well, we'll call this New Zealand.
Sir, they...
Steady on. You did all right.
They just kept on coming. And the grenades.
There's always an encore, Marcus. Sergeant, keep your medal on the crest.
News from Super Bay, sir. Right.
Waging peace.
So we're fairly doomed.
No one was ever fairly doomed, Marcus. Unless Troy was fairly doomed when Achilles got his blood up.
Hector died well, sir.
I like a good tale too, Marcus.
Bloody Abdul.
I wouldn't bet on it. Oh,
they're loud and firm leaves, mate.
Yeah, you'd believe anything. Oh.
Someone should go and see.
You first for the chop.
Oh, it has to be an Abdul.
You mean better be.
Yeah, it better be.
No bloody medals for saving wounded these days. Practice to be discouraged. Waste of motherland manpower.
Die, you bastard! Die!
Christ.
Fairly. So it was a goddamn Fernley.
Shut up!
I still believe in it, sir.
In Homer?
In the Empire, sir.
Don't make a bloody meal of it.
It still has its civilizing mission.
Tell it, Turks!
Sacrifice will be remembered, sir.
Sacrifice?
By the motherland, I mean.
Fools.
Sir?
Mothers have been known to go pouring off for the highest prices.
Pouring off?
Deserting their offspring, Harkness.
We can't be forgotten. Not altogether. Not altogether, sir.
Then we do even better. Sergeant.
They're coming.
They can fight, Harkness. They can die.
There's no nobility in besting a sham opponent, sir.
Their officers wouldn't swing the lead in Subla Bay.
Perhaps not, sir.
They make sense, Harkness. Sense. I'd give an arm to have Mustafa Kemal as my commanding officer.
You can't mean that, sir.
At least he bloody knows who's up here.
Yes, sir.
He loves his soil. God makes soil, and men make empires. I'd back soil any day.
What are
us then?
Who?
What are we?
By Christ, we're finding out, aren't we, Harkness?
You can smell the bait. The summit out there is crawling. There's one.
And with grenades, eh?
Must be. Finally, we can see the sods.
Look out! Send that one to him!
What you don't do is bloody look at the things!
I had to think.
Jesus!
Scared, aren't you, mate? Scared.
Shut up!
Don't worry. Death isn't so terrible. In the New Testament, the word used to mean place of safekeeping. Death. Place of safekeeping.
Christ!
Heroes, cowards, we are all gold to him. You need
me! Mate, I'll leave you alone!
I know. God has toyed with me, tested me, but I am steadfast.
Get away! Get away from me!
Shut up! Bloody bastard!
Come on, we all need him. We are fighting his war.
You're gonna shut up or be bashed!
I shall keep my peace.
You'd bloody better.
Get in some of the bayonets.
Bayonets, sir?
Bullets can't beat the buggers. Short charges, then retire.
Retire, sir?
To live to fight again another hour.
With respect, sir, doesn't it call for one final supreme effort?
What do you think this is?
4 months, one hill.
Our own tactics now.
Colonize, pioneer,
bash and slash, clear to McBear.
Sir, request permission to lead the first charge.
Sit on that telephone. Tell them all.
Your leg, sir.
Leg? Make young South useful too. Sergeant.
Colonel.
You give the order to retire,
if I can't. 30 yards, no more, fire one volley, then retire.
I got the picture.
Then it's bloody painted. Cutlery! Come on, I said cutlery! Quick!
You know what, Amaramba? I am right to call.
You telling us something?
Natty Toad, Metal Chuck. We fight the light, we fight the night.
Then we write that into our tactics too.
I just want you to know, you miserable, moaning bastards, that I hate you. Hate you, always have. Hate your bloody guts. Now let's go to our beds now!
Hello, Chunuk Bair here. Lieutenant Harkness speaking. We are in somewhat straitened circumstances here. Terrible. Last ditch. Hello, is anybody listening? Is anybody there?
What a stretch of
the... Right, stretch of Eric, can make it here, mate.
You let us, buddy. Thanks, though.
Damn it, man, there still must be a drop or two.
No, I'm sorry, sir. Sorry. Terribly sorry.
Christ, man, what about?
The water in the Turk trenches this morning. I kicked it over. I'm lying to you.
I know.
Yeah?
Don't tell me you're still bloody torturing yourself.
For being a fool, sir, about everything.
God, man, that was years ago. You won't lose this war on your own.
I could have done it too, you know. Been silly, kicked over that water, quite easy. But you didn't.
I never got the chance to. I'm just saying, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you all the same. Sorry I was so wretched with you.
I've been thinking serious.
Serious? Again, Scruffy, do you hear it?
Oh, there you go. I don't think things are too good. Too well organised, you know what I mean?
Oh, I wouldn't worry, they'll try harder next time.
Yeah, that's why you've got to make the most of this one.
The most, mate. Those trout and tower boat.
Yeah, mate, what about them?
Those still here. The lake room. The mountains.
And your sheilas.
And the sheilas and the footy.
I think you're trying to tell me something, Matt. I think you are.
Yeah, that's about the size of it, Scruff.
Buggers. Back! Will you again?
Sir, request permission to lend this charge.
I think I'm not up to it.
So I can't just wait for your discharge. Not doing nothing, no, sir.
You're long forgiven.
Not by myself, sir.
Thank God.
7 times now you've charged in that time I took over.
You'll get your chance.
Now, sir, I must insist.
Insist?
Sir, insist.
Sergeant, you'll call the command to retire if, that is, you don't hear one from Lieutenant Harkness first.
Thank you, sir.
Give them another merry motto to Raupaha.
Ki mata urunoa, ki mata peke. It's better to die like the shark. You live like the octopus.
Hear that, Harkness? Who needs Achilles and Hector?
I understand now, sir.
Christ. They're yours, Harkness. Mine. Yours.
Ready, sir?
It's whatever bloody you.
Firmers! All together! Always!
No!
Come on, Scruff.
It's all right, you tuggers. Makes a bugger to wake up from his deck.
We'll make him more comfortable, mate.
You reckon?
I reckon.
Nothing, sir. Mine's all dead.
Harkness?
There was a Turk wanted to die well, too. Stuffed. Only tells this time now.
Was it hard, Achilles? So very hard to die?
We didn't get that.
A lament, Sergeant, for a shark.
See the Wellington team fixing one too.
Well, I'm damned, look at that. Bayonet's been too excited to notice. Bullet, bloody bullet, must have fended the damn thing off.
Well, that's one way to do it.
Extraordinary. An omen.
Two ways to take it.
You take it the other way.
I thought you'd never ask.
If I don't see the day out, deliver it for me, personally, to General Sir Ian Hamilton, all his bloody entourage, a token of Chunuk Bair.
But have their guts with it.
Then try a twist for Harkness, MacDonald, all of them.
I wouldn't stop there, not just with Hamilton.
I shouldn't encourage you.
I don't need encouraging.
How long until dark?
Anywhere else, I'd say not long.
And how many charges have done us?
If we gave it a go, one or two of us might make it back to the beach.
No.
We still can't resist an order.
You know me better than that.
And you're carrying it out.
If this doesn't prove they're all insane, nothing will.
Hell of a way to win an argument. Killing ourselves to spite them.
And get them all sacked. This ended.
Tell me all the mugs would be shot. Then I'd take an interest.
Dead men can tell tales, Sergeant. We bloody will.
Until the live lies get going.
We might save other lives with our own. Good lives, New Zealand lives.
You don't see it out. You don't believe all that.
It helps.
You knew all along Chunuk Bair wouldn't win the war.
Late. All too late. We should have been up here months ago. The day of the landing. All waits and see, never a hope.
And you never believed the British would come anyway.
Not really.
Bastard.
I never fancied living, just to cough my guts out in some smelly old soldier's bed.
Jesus, you're as bad as Hamilton.
Well, at least there's half a pint worth of honour, tuppence worth of glory.
Same words, different country. That's the best you can do. Words to die for.
Give them better, Sergeant.
I'd give them something worth living for.
An international brotherhood?
Something like it.
Another empire and a damn sight worse.
We'll see.
Well, go on then. See. Take your own chances back to the beach. Get your brother out too. Go back and try and change the world, but see how many listen to a rabble-rouser who turned his back on Chunuk Bair.
Let's get it over with.
Sergeant South.
We're both caught by the short hairs.
It's not over yet. We can still do it if we hang on until dark. Others could make it up here then. Our own. Never say bloody die. That little bugger Bassett. He'd get a line through to God.
Don't cry,
mate. Answer it.
Chunuk Bair, Private Trotter, how are we? None the better for your bloody asking. Go on! Pull the other two! Go on! Get started!
Christ. Brigadier General Johnson, sir.
Give it here.
This is another person message from General Sir Ian Hamilton.
Then I may have to tell them both to get stuff more tactfully. Sir Connolly here. Yes, sir. You're coming through clear as a bell. Thanks, I might add to that little wizard, Bassett. Bassett? B-A-S-S-E-T-T. If you ever did the decent thing, you'd throw the determined little bugger some bronze. Yes, a Victoria Cross man. Yes, sir, I am no milder of temper. Yes, sir, I know Canterbury's been cut up trying to get through. I know Auckland and Otago are trying. And I know no one else is. Oh, by all means, sir, I should be most moved to hear our Commander-in-Chief's meditation.
That's buggered.
Buggered what?
My Victoria Cross.
Go on.
My only hopes now is
Johnson gets boosted up to get poor old Bassett arrested and give me his medal.
Jesus, Porky, you think of everything.
That's why you never pick winners at Trentham, Smiler. I'll tell you a dead cert for today. A bloody guru named Chunuk Bair. Shortest odds you ever saw. You don't get nothing back. Nothing. Nothing.
Nothing. Jesus, don't do it that way, mate. Not that way.
Shut that man up.
Shut him up. We'll put a bayonet in him.
Nothing.
Come on, Porky. You can't do that to us, mate. Bloody shut him up. Quick.
Nothing.
Porky, we'll all bloody go, mate. We'll all
nothing.
Bloody go.
Nothing.
We had our good times. We had, mate. We had.
Good God, man, speak up! That all you're playing, Mrs. Boy? You know damn well what it means.
Matt hung up his boots. He'd say, that's the size of it.
For Christ's sake, man, spit the plum out of your mouth and push the bottle back in. You know what that bullshit amounts to? We've been fed to the Turks!
What's the guts of it then? Still on our own?
We've been ordered to hold Chunuk Bair forever. Forever.
The British.
Consolidating, Sergeant. Forever. General Stockley, the new apple of the Imperial Eye, has decided not to go ashore until his bomb-proof HQ has been built in Silver Bay and all his artillery is unloaded.
Bloody artillery. And we haven't got a grenade.
Meanwhile, our Supreme Commander-in-Chief congratulates us on adding luster to our arms and winning a moral victory over death.
What?
You heard. And as an expression of his gratitude, General Sir Ian has also ordered God and the Imperial Navy to take an interest in us.
So that's bloody it.
Faith, Sergeant. Faith. If the Almighty knows his Imperial duty, we shall soon be witness to a miracle. The British reached galloping up Chunuk Bair.
Nothing matters.
We matter. We make ourselves matter. With our own story, Sergeant. Our own miracle. Our own legend. We're not going to get grenaded again.
Make it close again!
They can fight. They can die. We've got one more. We've got one charge of us yet.
Come on, Smiler. Get off your ass. You're the Colonel, mate. If you want to be a legend, you do it bloody right!
What's the matter?
Put your stomach in your chest now, let's do it!
What do you think you're doing? You've got to let me grow up!
Jesus! What in Christ do you think I've been trying to let you do?
Leave it, Sergeant. He's won. Bloody won. Get him behind me.
Good luck, mate.
The Lord is my shepherd. Shall not want.
Ready? Ready.
He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters.
Damn you! Damn you all now! Shoulder. I've done my dash.
That was close.
Try another look. It might be the sergeant on his way back.
Nothing. Wait a bit.
Yes.
Nothing.
Miraculous. Something's happening down there.
Warship. It's a British warship. It's moving fast. Moving very fast. What's going on?
It's hard to say, sir.
How long until dark?
It's nearer.
Goodbye, the light.
follow the night.
Yeah, there should be more friendlies soon, sir.
Too late. It's all too late.
Jesus, Sarge! You alright?
Yeah, I'm alright.
Fred?
Yeah, he's alright too.
Where?
Back there.
Where?
Gut. Throat. Took mine.
Those shots.
I said I'd get him through.
Jesus Christ. You.
Who else?
Sergeant.
Don't you bloody butter me. That's it. That's my war.
Sergeant.
Colonel, the British warship.
I'll let it play, sink.
No, it's swung round, side on.
Token show. Typical. Not a Turk in sight. There it goes. The flash. First salvo. There.
Couldn't do us. Only they could. Shut up, or you'll get your issue too. I said, bloody shut up, or. Who's that?
A tiger, Auckland.
Come to get you off, mate.
Wellington's here to stay.
Bloody bastards.
Chunuk Bair. Sergeant South speaking. Personal message for General Surrey and Hamilton. Yes, mate, very personal. Chunuk Bair has been held forever. Forever. The last man's messages. Rot in hell! Fuck your war! Fuck you all! Forever.
Bayonet. A bloody bayonet!
Fed.
Bugger. It's no use to you now.
Wait and see. Wait and bloody see!
another country, I've got to reform one over there on behalf of the college.
Shirt. It's so not.
Hello, Daffy.
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 St. Kent's is a good school.
Ha ha ha.
It hurts, and I am too sexy for Milan, too sexy for Milan, New York.
It's the crocodile hunter.
Oh, God.
Let's go somewhere else.
You gotta get down.
I hope that someone untoward takes that offensive object and finds a very inconvenient orifice and rams it.
It's amazing. It's major embarrassment time. Louise Chambly is having a birthday today from King's College. Her wonderful friends have decided to embarrass her in front of 2,000 people, so happy birthday, Louise.
Yeah.
Love is in the air, everywhere I look around. Love is in the air, every sight and every sound. And I don't know if I'm being fooled, don't know if I'm being wise, but it's something that I must believe in, and it's there when I look in your eyes. Love is in the air, in the whisper of the trees. Love is in the air, in the thunder of.
That's what I said now. Princes, princes who adore you. just go ahead now. One last diamond in his pocket, and that's a friend now. This one who wants to buy you rockets, ain't it his head now? Marry him or marry me, I'm the winner, let me
out. Get down to the chief, 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 super, 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 hey, super, 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 hey.
Just go ahead now, and if you like to tell me, maybe just go ahead now, and if you wonder about me flowers, just go ahead now, and if you like to talk for hours, just go ahead now, and if you want to call me, baby, just go ahead now, and if you like to tell me, maybe just go ahead now, and if you like to buy me flowers, just go ahead now, and if you.
And thanks to the man behind the camera.
Thank you all, it has been a good experience. The tape is about to run out. The red light is flashing, so I say goodbye, good night. That's a wrap.
Just go ahead now, if you want to buy the blood. Just go ahead now.